HamRadioNow, day two, the big trip to Seattle at the Tapper Digital Communications Conference. We are leaving Gallipolis, Ohio, right on the border of West Virginia. That's where we spent the night. I'm trying to find my way back onto the highway. Ah, yes, there's the sign to West 35. This is the same route that I would take to Dayton. In fact, we're going to go right through Dayton, which is going to be a little bit weird, because I'm not used to going through Dayton without going to Dayton, to the Hamfest. It's like the city evaporates, for all intents and purposes, after the Hamfest weekend is over, but I know it's still there. I made a couple adjustments. I moved the mirror up so you can get a better view out the windshield. I did get day one put online last night. Didn't do a few other things I should have done, but I got that done. And not sure I'm going to get day two done tonight. I got a lot more driving I got to do. I got to make up some things. And might even have a chance to see some family, a brother I haven't seen in a while, if I can get far enough, be on the far side of Illinois. And I better get that far, because otherwise I'm not going to make it to Seattle. All right, here we go on 35. Oh, we've done one more thing. I thought I had left my DVAP behind. I couldn't find it in the car. I usually leave it sitting in the car, able to plug in. And I thought I'd left it behind, but I opened up a box, and as I was getting stuff ready for last night, whoa, it's foggy up here. And there it was. So I plugged it in. It's running on the laptop computer, and the phone, the Samsung Galaxy Note 2, is being the hotspot to Verizon for internet, and it should be working. I'm listening to 30C. I'm not hearing anybody. I've got the echo function on. Let's test it. Testing 1-2, KM4AQ testing.
Testing 1-2, KM4AQ testing.
That appears to be working. So maybe we won't record quite so much today. I kind of really rambled on about a lot of things yesterday, but we'll see. Merging onto 35, let's head to Seattle. Not all the way, but as far as we can get today. Whatever's next will be next.
12 hours, 35 minutes, 1 Universal Time.
AC40 testing. Is this frequency in use, please?
The frequency is pretty quiet, KM4AQ.
Oh, hey, KM4AQ from AC40.
Okay, there you go. Your signal is huge.
Yeah, yours too. You're about between S7 and S9.
Yeah, that's what I'm seeing. In fact, I was seeing a stronger a second ago, so probably a little bit of QSB. Well, I'm on US 35, and if you remember where Gallipolis was, just across the river from West Virginia, that's where I spent the night, and that's where I'm headed west from now.
Oh, okay, yeah, I get to Gallipolis about three times a year, once to Dayton, and usually about two other trips in that direction, so well done. Yeah, I'm just pulling up the map now.
Yeah, I got a pretty late start yesterday. Had a lot of things to get done, and then just before I was leaving, I found oil dripping on the garage floor. I'd had the oil changed at the Jiffy Lube, and I went back and they found that they had screwed the oil filter on just a little bit wrong. So next time I get a free oil change.
Ooh, that's good, man. I'm glad it wasn't any permanent damage.
Yeah, caught it quick, but it delayed me even yet another 45 minutes, almost an hour. So it was pretty late start getting out. That's why I only got this far. I was hoping to get to about Indianapolis, but we're on the road now. And hey, you're on television. Your voice is on television.
What's on television?
Your voice. I'm recording you. I've got the camera set up here pointing out the window. The microphone's sitting at the speaker.
Okay, hello everybody. Okay, so I've pulled the map here. We're about 735 I between Gallipolis and Dayton.
Rocky Hill. 10 miles from Jackson, 63 miles from Chillicothe.
Okay. I see Chillicothe. I was too far up, but I see Rocky Hill now. That's good. Rocky Hill looks like it's about 5 or 6 miles from Jackson. Well, you're doing good. You're on your way. When do you plan to arrive?
I'm hoping to get there Wednesday night, give myself a Thursday to get settled in and set up and things tested out. I'm not sure when I can actually get to the venue, but that's also my cushion day in case travel falls way behind, they can't catch up or have a mechanical problem or whatever. Really need to be there Thursday night.
Okay, so you got a few days of leisurely driving. It should be a great trip with that much time built into the schedule. That's really good.
Yay. And you are talking on that dipole we strung up over your house and made a television show out of, if I am not mistaken.
That's right. I'm sorry to say it's the only functional HF antenna here. The tri-bander I've let down the telescoping mast because I have some problems with it. So that dipole we made is the only HF antenna now. It's got to carry the day. And yep, that's what we're using. Thanks for the good signal report.
KN4AQ. Well, the band's in good shape today. I was listening on 40 for a few seconds, and that's in good shape. And this hearing a bunch of folks on other channels, but fortunately, this one was clear. So you're doing good. In fact, I rarely hear signals on 60 meters this strong. Of course, with the somebody on 5.2, I think. With it was on CB. Yeah, the CB radio popped up. With the power increase to 100 watts, of course, everyone's 3 dB stronger now.
You changed radios and went from 50 to 100, is that right?
No, the FCC changed the rules and let us go from 50 watts ERP to 100.
Oh, I see. I should have known that. Okay. All right, well, your signal's dropped off a little since we started, but still plenty strong. You're full, about between S5 and S7 most of the time. The copy's very easy.
Well, I could do what most hams do and speculate wrongly that the signal is weaker because I'm farther away, because I've gone, like 10 miles since we've been talking. So that's clearly the reason why the signal's dropped off.
And you went over the hill, right?
Oh, yeah. I went to the other side of the hill, too.
And maybe there's a tower between us.
Somebody was saying that at a public service event I was at. He's having trouble with the repeater that we were shadowed from, and there was a cell tower about two blocks away, and he says that's in the way.
Oh my, somebody was making a joke, yeah?
I don't think so, but it sometimes gets hard to tell. If somebody's got really dry humor, you might not be able to tell if they're making a joke. Let's see, I'm going by a substation here. I might not be able to hear anything.
We'll see if it's clean. I'll say nothing important whatsoever while you're going by. And then see whether you heard the nothingness or just the blather. Are you past it yet?
Yeah, and it was quiet. It didn't make any noise. All kinds of big transmission lines, and they all sound pretty quiet.
Wow, nice. Very nice. Good. Will that work? Well, it was a long day for me yesterday, too. In fact, I left about the time you did. Well, except for the time zones. I left about the time you did and got home just shortly before we spoke on the phone. Happy to be home. Happy to get back to the work at hand here. And Jesus, I should get on the radio again.
Yeah, you had a pretty good long trip. Much farther. No, actually not much farther than I'm going, but faster. Probably about the same distance, or at least similar. You were in England, and how far away is that?
I think it's about 3,500 miles. I'm not sure exactly how far, so it might be a little farther, but it was definitely a lot faster. Didn't have to swim.
Yeah. Well, My road trip is 2,800 miles, but that is not as the crow flies. That is as... Finish the sentence.
as the crow walks and rolls a flat tire.
You remembered. All right, very good. Well, you got a big project, so I'm going to let you go. We'll dial you up on some band as I get farther and farther away. It'll have to be a higher and higher frequency.
Okay, let's go for around lunchtime and then maybe this evening.
Sounds good. Talk to you later. AC4ZO, KM4AQ Mobile in southeastern Ohio.
Okay, drive like a raging lunatic there. KM4AQ, AC4ZO.
Hello there, Joe the Hap here, KC.RP in a rather rainy and cool Chicago area this morning. The band sounds better than it has, over.
Roger,
well, that is mid-cars going on in the background. That's the 7258 Midwest mobile service. It's making noise here. Lots of radios. That was Hap Holly, the rain report guy. He's interviewed me before. I guess I got to interview him someday. So I'm going to try to get in, but you heard the pileup when she made that first call. Well, we'll try.
Signal is as good as I've heard in many, many a week. So.
All right, we had Hap and we had Whopper and Fries, and there were a whole boatload of stations in there with those two, and I only got those two, so we'll sit back and sort them out.
Alpha Quebec Mobile.
All right, I had a station that ended in Quebec, and I had a mobile. Who's the mobile station?
NADPD Mobile,
Jim. Oh, NADPD, all right. Who is the station that ended in Quebec?
Kilo November 4, Alpha Quebec, Mobile in Ohio.
Oh, I didn't realize you were mobile too, but I still had to take the mobile stations one at a time. Kilo November 4, Alpha Quebec, Mobile in Ohio, go ahead.
Hey Joan, no problem, no hurry on this end. My name is Gary, home is Raleigh, North Carolina. Destination, Seattle, Washington. Don't expect to get there today. Tonight's destination is Rock Island, Illinois, where my brother lives, and we'll visit him this evening. All right, 73, and back to you, Joan. Thanks a lot. KM4AQ Mobile near Dayton, Ohio.
All right, sounds good, Gary. Well, you're well on your way along, man.
Yeah, Howard, hello out there. The frequency is in use, so thought I'd let him know, Gary, that something's going on here.
Yeah, not
our
deal.
All right, 73, thanks,
Al.
We'll catch you later.
All right, well, the frequency is in use. And can you see that bridge up there, or is the mirror in the way? you'll see what the bridge is crossing in just a moment. We are about to go across the Mississippi, the division of the country. We're heading to the western half of the country, officially into Iowa. And that will be the Mississippi River. Let me slide over here so maybe you can see a little bit of it anyway. I tilted the camera off to the right a little in hopes of being able to let you see a little bit more of the panoramic vistas, but mostly I think you just see it in that post. But down there is the Mississippi, so we are in zero land. And heading west and beginning day three and listening to mid-cars.
Tyler, working on the corn up here already in Fox 4, HAC 73.
Well, we are on the western side of Iowa, touched Nebraska a little bit.
34, Papa Yankee.
We are on 17 meters. Maybe we should try a little DX. I'm used to doing this from the East Coast. Some pretty good signals from out here in the Midwest.
Great to hear you. So you are a 5 and 5. 55 here on the...
This guy is in France.
QSL, Bob, thanks for the report on Michigan. Condition would change, not very stable now. I have a lot of...
He sounds strong. But he's not doing anything on the S meter. It's S zero.
No hover simulation. No.
Shows you how low the noise level is.
November 9 Alpha Uniform Yankee Foxtrot 4 Hotel Echo Charlie. Back to you, Bob.
Not here on the 9, wherever he is. I'm hearing East Coast stations.
QRZ Foxtrot 4 Hotel Echo Charlie. Bending space right.
Kilo November 4 Alpha Quebec Mobile.
Well, kilowatt to the one, maybe. Kilowatt, number one, K1. Whiskey, Victor,
United, your 5-9.
Yeah, here in the East Coast stuff, I was hearing a guy down in Texas. Pretty typical of a band like 17 meters. It's got a big skip zone.
United, near Boston, Massachusetts.
Although it'll be a little shorter if it's E-skip, but I don't think there's any E-skip today. This is, I'm pretty sure this is all going to be F. So this miserable sunspot cycle is at least working today.
Hotel Echo Charlie, kilowatt one. Whiskey Victor, United. And those are the working conditions here, Freddy.
So the question will be, can he hear me?
WCU.
It's getting weaker.
Thanks for the information on your setup with the log periodic.
And it's getting strong.
I'm not sure how the path I remember is a very popular antenna.
So this is a very pleasant DX station. In France, you know, it's not all that rare, so he's taken the opportunity to talk a little bit. Not all 10-second wham-bam contacts.
Nice setup with the 5000, not changed the level to the IQ here. I had only bought the 2000.
Of course, all they're talking about is radio equipment.
The 5000, or I would have waited. I had a 51,000 D. The front-to-back ratio is not as good as you might find on some of the yachts. And the gain.
Okay, now I'm getting bored.
You might find on some of the other beams. But the fact that it is a flat SWR. Across all of the bands that I'm interested in. And the fact
log periodic blah blah blah.
There's nothing mechanical.
Look it up.
Very light.
That's what it'll say in the antenna book. Log periodic blah blah blah.
Lifted over his head and dropped down onto the mounts. Not very heavy, but sometimes I have a good surprise to working the ZK station on the tractor, ZDL, Fox Oscar, and etc. Not real problem.
Wow, he's nice bouncing all the way up to S1.
The last of May, during the night, I'm working during the night, and I had a nice report from the guys in Japan, in North America. It's time the guys are really surprised to working with a tractor mobile. I believe just only two or three guys are really.
Oh, by the way, the geography has turned flat. Just barely seeing over the tops of the corn.
Yeah,
eastern Iowa and some of Nebraska we were going through was... very rolling, but this is a glacier deal. It's flat as a pancake here.
Comet antenna system, the monodam. And I received this model, the Mike 200 Alpha Hotel, maybe. I received just from 2 weeks ago. And
that's the antenna that I'm using, Tar Heel 218.
The position was taking in October and November here, brother. Yeah, very good, Freddy.
Well, this has gone on longer than a courtesy rag chew from a DX station, so I guess he just wants to talk.
And I have been on your website. 73, my friend.
Fox 4, Hotel Echo Charlie. This is K1.
Whiskey, United, over. Yes, Don, K1, Whiskey, Victor, United. You're picking 20 of a 9 now, 20 of a 9, very good copy. So many things.
He is speaking S3.
The mobile and extra.
Maybe he'll hear me.
To cross you soon, with a great pleasure, Bob. And congratulations for your beautiful check. I like the pictures. Also, I choose it from on the table. We are going to tell it. They're very, very beautiful.
That ignition noise you're hearing is from the car that's just passing me. It's not from me. There's no ignition noise in this car.
Okay, Freddy. Well, thank you for looking.
I must tell you, in all honesty, when I retired, my wife did that for me. Built the room, taking it, did the woodwork.
No, that noise is from a truck that's passing by.
Just one last question. It's not indiscreet. What is your age? How many years old are you?
73.
Oh, you're very young. Many thanks, 73, Bob. Bye-bye. 73, bye-bye.
Kilo November 4, Alpha, Quebec, Mobile.
Station from East Coast, please. Just wait 1 minute. I listen to station, I believe it's Victor Echo 6 or November 6, I'm not sure. The station with the number 6 on the call, please, over. Any else from West Coast, please, Kilo them.
Ah, darn, West Coast. I don't think I'm on the West Coast yet.
LA 4, UOA, I'm calling West Coast of USA. Looking for the West Coast of USA, Lima Alpha 4, United Ocean America.
Now, would it be really rude of me to call, even though he's not making any contacts? I don't know. I know some hams would just go ahead and call.
Looking for West Coast, secure West Coast, Lima Alpha 4.
Got a good signal. I have no idea where Lima Alpha 4 is.
LA 4, UOA, I'm beaming West Coast.
You are making it to Western Iowa, KN4AQ Mobile.
I'm looking for the West Coast, secure West Coast.
Hey, he's ignoring me.
West Coast, Lima Alpha.
And I'll officially declare myself a lid, and it's time to buy some gas. Oh, here comes Sioux City, Iowa.
One more call, looking for West Coast, Lima Alpha 4.
Okay, so I didn't have the tape rolling, but he explained why he was looking for the West Coast. It's because he doesn't get to work the West Coast very much. Usually no propagation into there. So he was just trying.
Nothing heard. QSZDX, I'm calling DX. I'm looking for DX, CQ, CQ DX. Calling a CQ, calling a CQ DX. From Lima Alpha 4, Uniform Oscar Alpha. LA 4, UOA, calling a CQ DX and standing by.
Kilo November 4, Alpha Quebec, Mobile.
Mike to Juliet.
Mobile station, the mobile station, I think I heard you earlier as well. Call again the mobile station.
Whiskey 7, Oscar, Mike to Juliet.
Kilo November 4, Alpha Quebec, Mobile.
Something Whiskey 7, call again.
Whiskey 7, Oscar, Mike to Juliet.
If that's not Mobile,
Oscar,
I'll call him a lid.
I'm not sure about the last letter there,
boy. Whiskey 7, Oscar, Mexico, Japan. Whiskey 7, Oscar, Mexico, Japan. Over.
Yeah, okay. I copy now. W7OMJ. Whiskey 7, Oscar, Mexico, Japan.
So I guess we're both lids.
5 and 7.
QSL, you're 5 and 7 into Surprise, Arizona. The name is Matt. Mike Alpha, Tango, Tango, QSL.
A little bit here, and see if it helps a little. Name is Tour, Tango, Ontario Radio, TOR, and I'm located on the south coast of Norway. W7OMJ.
Okay, Norway.
United Ocean.
I'm going to run out of gas trying to work him.
Alrighty, thank you very much for the contact and good DX to you and have a great rest of your day there. Lima Alpha 4, United Oscar Alpha from Whiskey 7, Oscar Mike Juliet 73, thank you.
Best 73, Matt, W7OMJ. Lima Alpha 4, United, Ocean, America. Bye-bye.
73.
Kilo November 4, Alpha, Quebec, Mobile.
That's Lima Alpha 4, United, Ocean, America, QSTX.
Kilo November 4, Alpha, Quebec, Mobile.
November, Mike calling.
Kilo 7, Kilo November, Mike, you're 59. QSET looking for DX. Long 17, Lima Alpha 4, United, Ocean, America.
Go Foxtrot Mobile.
Kilo November 4, Alpha, Quebec, Mobile.
The station with zero, zero in the call, try again.
Back on the road, we try to work some DX again in a moment, but what I wanted to mention here is while I was in the little boy's room checking email, it's what you always do on a phone when you're on the road, I saw a ARL bulletin with a big surprise in it. Wayne Green, W2NSD, passed away. It's a couple days ago. I think they said the 13th, but Friday. I think just about everybody who's watching knows who Wayne Green was. Brand new hams might not. In fact, in my poem, A Ham's Night Before Christmas, I've got a line about Wayne Green. Talking about the little old Santa. It's too far to tell. It can hardly be seen, but I thought for a moment it might be Wayne Green. That's the biggest laugh line in the poem. But there's always some people in the audience, some newer hams that weren't around in Wayne's era. Wayne, of course, was the editor of 73 Magazine, founder of 73 Magazine, edited CQ for a few years. And so the new hams don't know who he was. He was the very definition of the word curmudgeon. An ARL member, but always an ARL critic. And back in the day, I've been a life member of ARL since 1974. But not always, real strong ARL supporter. In fact, during the repeater era, the 75 mile an hour speed limit. During the, that's the first one of those that I've seen heading west here. As repeaters were building, ARL kind of ignored them. The ARL was primarily HF and DX and didn't understand what this repeater thing was all about. So we got little assistance from them in organizing the way FM and repeaters were rapidly filling the VHF bands. Wayne Green paid a lot of attention to it. In fact, Bill Pasternak, WA6ITF, had a column in the early, in the 70s era, 73 Magazine called Looking West, and a lot of information about repeaters, and the rest of the magazine was not all repeater-focused, but had repeater stuff in it, but QST did not. QST didn't ignore, and ARL didn't ignore repeaters. There was a lot of information about FM, more technical than organizational infrastructure needs that we had at the time. I mean, we needed technical stuff, but we also needed to figure out band plans and how things were going to work with fixed frequency repeaters. ARL didn't help very much with that. So I was a 73 subscriber and sort of a Wayne Green fan, although anybody that is always itching for a fight somewhere, I get suspicious of, because it's like they've got an ideology and they have to, it's the hammer and nail thing. Everything they look at, they have to fit into their ideology and figure out what it is they're going to criticize or support, but mostly criticize. I don't want to be that person. Wayne was kind of that way. 73 folded, a decade or so ago, and Wayne has faded from ham radio, not from publishing, not from online. He still had still been very active doing stuff online. I'll use the word health nut type stuff. and probably a lot of other things. I wasn't paying very much attention to them. But when someone passes away who's been that iconic in ham radio, you have to stop and take note of it. So we'll miss you, Wayne. Good luck wherever you are. Maybe you can work some DX up there. Assuming you're up there, I guess. So speaking of working DX, maybe I can. Let's see if I have a little more luck here on 17. You know, maybe I miss being on the East Coast with an easier shot to Europe, because I'm not having very much luck here. But yeah, we'll tune around and see what we can get.
Amplifier running about 800 watts.
Yeah, 800 watts. I'm still at 17 meters. I don't know if you can... Ooh, too low. I don't know if you can see the dial here. So I don't know where HK3 is either. I don't know my DX prefixes very well.
Okay, Chuck, hearing you quite well. WD8 Baker X-ray Sugar Mobile. In Virginia, HK3 Charlie. Name is John, KOHN. And just north of the capital city, Bogota. Back to you, Chuck. Go ahead.
North of the capital city of something, but I didn't catch what. And I'm not here in the Virginia Beach Mobile. I've been here in the East Coast up until now, but he's not coming through at all.
Thanks, Chuck. Good afternoon, HK3 Charlie.
Kilo November 4, Alpha Quebec, Mobile.
Hello. Hello, Yankee Tango Mobile. 1, Victor Echo 1, X-ray, X-ray.
Yeah, I could tell I was doubling with somebody who is strong here.
Hotel 1 X-ray. Okay, that's close enough for government work.
66 miles to Sioux Falls, South Dakota.
This is our first contact. MQDH is Bogota, just north of the capital city.
Okay, Bogota, so he's south of Central America, or South America, Colombia.
An excellent DX audio, really, really good DX audio.
He's peaking S1 at best.
Here. ICOM transceiver and a small two-element antenna, about 15 meters above ground. Good to hear you, and thanks for shouting. Thanks for waving your hand. OH1XX, HK3 Charlie.
Kilo 4, Sierra Bravo.
So, it's always a question when you can't hear the guy someone's talking to, DX station. When do you call him? Sometimes he'll finish up with a QRZ or a CQ, and sometimes he'll just listen for stations and start calling when the guy he's talking to is done.
Yeah, that's right.
But if you can't hear that guy, you don't know when to call. And so you'll hear guys like that that just called. And so is that lid like? Because the other guy was still talking. Somebody out there is going to say there's an established procedure, but in my almost 45 years of hamming, I don't know what it is.
A daytime high, a nighttime low about 6. Very comfortable. And the humidity is always around.
I've got almost 50 years of hamming. I can't do the math.
Hope to see you again. Hope to catch you in the CQ worldwide at the end of October.
The signal's peaking a little bit.
And if you need a card for this band, know that
S3
I
to S5.
The world, but I have same mailing address in Miami, Florida. Thank you, Hanu. Good night. OH1XX, HK3 Charlie.
Kilo November 4, Alpha Quebec, Mobile. Kilo November 4, Alpha Quebec, Mobile. Yep, see, he said the guy he was talking to got covered up as he was making his last transmission, so because the pileup started calling. We didn't know when. And I joined in like a lid with everybody else. I can do some things that are very lid-like.
Okay, Jen, very good. Sugar Papa 610, go Golf Radio. Go ahead, Chad. HK3 Charlie.
He's learning his lesson. Everybody wait. Go ahead, Jen.
OH1XX.
And there's somebody who didn't get the message.
Kilo 4 Sierra Bravo.
KK4SSB, you did not get the message.
SD6TGR, HK3 Charlie. Good night, Jen. Thank you.
7 November, Kilo Bravo 3.
So here's the pile up. And best I can tell, he never came back on to say CQ or QRZ, so he's inviting the early pileup by not doing that.
Just going to rotate the antenna a little closer to you. K7 Kilo November Mike.
You know, I just realized I have absolutely no credibility giving advice on working DX. But when has that ever stopped anybody, including me? Well, that guy's in Virginia. I think I heard him work on the other station I tried to work. It's got a flagpole antenna. He's doing pretty good. Oh, can you see that? All that corn? Isn't that beautiful?
Bogota at 9 million people is bad enough.
Whoa.
Sao Paulo is big, like Mexico City, as you know.
9 million is not big.
Not sure where they're going. A7KNM, HK3 Charlie.
Okay, now when do we call? When do we call? At least I can hear the other guy.
Yep, so long, Curtis. You were covered up that time, but I heard enough of you to know that you had just turned it over. Good night. See you again. Hasta pronto, HK3 Charlie.
Kilo November 4, Alpha Quebec, Mobile.
Kilo Victor 3, Oscar Victor Bravo. Good evening, Alan. Booming again as usual. All right, so long, Alan. HK3 Charlie.
Kilo November 4, Alpha Quebec, Mobile.
Mike, W9, DMM.
Getting to figure out what he does, most of the time anyway, to cue us to call. When we can't hear the station he's talking to. And I hate it when they just disappear. Yep. So that's my argument for channelizing the bands in a nutshell. I'll go see if I can work somebody, and maybe I'll fire up the camera again if I've actually started to work them. You've seen enough of the frustration. That's Ham Radio. Nothing special.
Number 4 Alpha again, please.
Kilo November 4 Alpha Quebec Mobile.
Kilo November 4 Alpha Quebec Mobile. Good evening. Thanks very much. Name's John and Gary. I'm hearing you quite well. It got a little wild and woolly and ragged for a sec, so I just thought I'd just stand by until the noise went away, and it appears to. Go back to you. Name is John, and I'm near Bogota, Gary, and great mobile signal from Gary. Go ahead.
Okay, John. You're peaking about S5 here. I'm not in Cary. I am in South Dakota, just a little bit south of Sioux Falls. I was listening to your pileups come and go, and I'm glad I just stuck around and had a chance to get in, because I wasn't competing very well with everybody else. Back to you, John, KN4EQ.
Thank you very much for standing by, and glad you're hearing okay. All right, runway. Travel safely, Gary. Watch out for the other guy and have a good safe trip to destination. I think you said Seattle. Good night, HK3 Charlie.
Yep, Seattle's correct. 73, John, good talking to you. KN4AQ Mobile.
You bet, HK3 Charlie.
I'm tempted to say, and that is how we do that. But the fact is, I got lucky. I mean, what happened was I just had the radio parked. I never tuned off once he announced that he was going to go away for a while. I'm not sure that's on the tape or not. He said somebody else came off frequency just a little bit. Yeah, I think it was where he was talking about my desire to see things channelized, which should get me some mail. So he just went away for a while, and I didn't move the radio, and he came back, and I thought, well, here's my chance. Maybe the pileup is gone, and indeed they were. So I got lucky. AC4ZO, AC4ZO, KN4AQ Mobile. Jeff, are you around?
You're a little weak there. I got
an
S5 noise floor, and you're just above it, so the copy's difficult, but let's try it. Go ahead.
Yay. From near Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Well, you're about S3 or S4, but I've got a zero noise level, so you're doing good. Point your antenna this way.
Okay, you're near Sioux Falls, South Dakota, I think you said?
Yeah, just coming up on Sioux Falls, South Dakota, so rotate your dipole and point it at me.
To turn the rest of the world, dipole won't rotate. Hey, well, that's pretty good. How are you doing on your schedule? Are you pretty close?
I'm a couple hours behind, and I got a little bit of work to do for a client. I got to do some billing, not actual production work, but I got to do some billing. So I can't afford to get in real late. And maybe I'll output this video and make a day 2, day 3 combined podcast. I didn't make it day 2 because I visited my brother last night in Rock Island. And it also looks like I'm not going to touch North Dakota, the only state in the continental U.S. and then Hawaii, which I've been to, never been to Alaska. The only state in the continental U.S. that, as far as I can tell, I've never been in. And I'm going to get close, but I don't have enough time to go up there. Add a few hours, and I don't have those hours to add. Maybe tomorrow I'll change my mind and zip up there, because I'll still be just south of it.
Well, that's a shame. That's a shame you have to work while you're on this epic journey, but I guess it's good that you're making money. And you had mentioned the other day that you were looking forward to clipping off a corner in North Dakota because it was the only state you hadn't been in the continental U.S., but sounds like you're not going to make it. Oh, God. Just for a couple hours behind schedule, you don't think you can make it up later down the road?
Well, I'm looking at the time that it's estimating for me to get to Seattle, and it shows 26 hours, which I've got to split across 2 days, plus shaving off another hour or two today, 24 hours. That'd be 2 12-hour days. Those are long days, but if I get enough work done tonight, including emailing and making some contacts with the folks that are going to be assisting me at Seattle, then maybe I'll put myself in for it. The last day, Wednesday, I can afford it to be a real long day because I'll just be getting in late. I've got Thursday to recuperate and get my equipment set up. We've heard from the hotel they're being kind of, I don't know if they're being obstinate about it or if the room is going to be real busy, but we won't be able to even set foot in it to start setting stuff up until Friday morning. And I've got a lot to set up, so be an early Friday morning, but that will leave my Thursday fairly free for just checking everything out and making sure it's all ready.
Okay, I think you've turned it back to me. Bad news, there's some QSB. The man is taking a dive, and I can just barely hear you in the noise, but I can't copy anything. Like I heard somebody say, I'm 2 meters once. I can tell you're in there, but there's absolutely no intelligence.
I could be talking for a half hour and there could be no intelligence. I may have to call him on the phone
okay,
again.
There's no copy at all now. No copy at all, Chuck. All right, well,
be careful driving. Everybody tells you that. Drive like a maniac, and we'll try for you tomorrow again then. 73 KM4AQ from AC4ZO.
Yeah, your signal's coming back up a little bit here. You never disappeared, but I've got no noise level. Turn off your routers, turn off your Ethernet, turn off your computers, and your noise level will go away. 73, AC4ZO, KM4AQ Mobile, South Dakota.
Okay, you came way up that time to where you were originally, but I can tell the QSB will be coming and going until nightfall. 73, be careful driving, AC4ZO.
Like you said, I'll drive like a maniac at currently 72 miles an hour, 3 miles an hour below the posted speed limit. 73, KN4AQ Mobile.